Hey, what's up? Welcome to a new Quickedit video. This time with an image of the Lake of Constance in southern Germany. And you can already see this was shot shortly after sunset. And for this photo, my goal is to reintroduce some sunset colors. Basically, I want to keep most of the blue color tones on the left side, but I want to add a big area on the right side, right where the sun is setting, and just make it a lot warmer and add some subtle glow effect to it. But before I continue with the editing, let's first take a look at the before and after images. Alright, and I'm using Adobe Photoshop for this edit. So right now I'm in the Camera Raw editor, as you can see, and I want to start by activating the lens correction settings. So here we can remove the chromatic aberration, and for this shot the profile correction will have a rather big impact, as the handrail right there is a little close to the upper edge. I don't know if you can see it, but right now it's a little distorted. When I'm activating this setting, it will get fixed, or at least look a bit better. Then let's check the basic stuff. For this shot, I want to go with the Adobe Landscape profile, which will give me some more base saturation to work with. And for the white balance, I think I actually want to increase the temperature. This will already give me warmer colors throughout the image. And for this photo, I also want to have a slightly magenta color cast, so I'm also increasing the tint. Okay, then let's play around with the overall brightness of the image. I think first I want to drop the exposure just to make it a bit darker. And to not lose details in the darkest spots, I am simply increasing the shadows here. I could also add some whites. And then to get some nice detail and structure, I'm increasing the texture and the clarity. Okay, of course I want to have some more saturation going on here. In this case, I want to boost the vibrance and drop the saturation. And I just think this will give a better looking style instead of just increasing the saturation. And of course, for this image, there are a few local adjustments. I want to start with the gradiated filter, which I have applied for the top, as you can see right here. And I'm using this one to simply darken the sky some more by dropping the exposure. By the way, the reason the sky is the darkest in the middle of the image is because I use the polarization filter, which sometimes, depending on the direction, causes this effect, which is rather annoying and can easily destroy a good image. I think in this case it's not that obvious to the viewer, so I have to see if I want to fix it later in Photoshop. Then let's check the radial filters. Again, I just have applied one on the far right side, and that's because I want to add this nice glow effect right there. And therefore, I'm increasing the blacks. Also, I want to make this area a lot warmer, so let's just increase the temperature. And I also want to add some magenta tones in here, so I'm increasing the tint. Alright, that's it for the local adjustments already. Then let's head over to the HSL adjustments and into the saturation tab. Here I simply want to boost the blue saturation some more. And maybe orange and yellow as well. Okay, and then of course a very important part for this image, the split toning. For the highlights, of course I want to apply a warm color tone. And let's increase the saturation. Now you can already see this will have a very, very big effect on this image. Okay, and then let's apply a cold color tone for the shadows. And again, boost the saturation. Okay. And last but not least, I want to sharpen the image. And that's it for the camera raw adjustments, and we can open it to finish it in Photoshop. And first, of course, I want to remove some of those sensor spots using the spot healing brush right there. Just paint over them. Then let's add the glow effect I was talking about earlier. Therefore, I'm applying a new layer. Switch its blending mode to hard light, grab the brush tool, and you can see I already have dropped the brush opacity to around 10%. Now I'm holding down the Alt key and click in the area where I want to apply the glow effect. This way I can pick up the right color for this area and then make sure I'm using a very soft brush and just carefully paint in a few times right there. And I think that's already enough, as I don't want to overdo it. So next I'm selecting those two layers and hit Ctrl E to merge them. And now I want to check the Nick collection for some final effects. Right away I want to go with the Brilliance Warmth filter, just to adjust the colors a little bit more by increasing the warmth. And you see this will have a really nice effect on the whole image. Maybe even play around with the perceptual saturation. Okay, then I'm checking the Nick collection again. This time I'm using the polarization filter, which again will just intensify those color tones throughout the image. And you can actually see this will help with the bending issue in the sky caused by the polarization filter I had on my lens. So let's go with something like this. And then I want to check the Nick collection one more time. This time, since I want to have a dreamy look over the whole image, I'm going with the classical soft focus filter. As you can see, this will add some blurriness without actually losing the sharpness of those objects. And now let's see. I think I'm going with the second diffusion method because it looks the best to me. Okay, looks pretty cool to me. Now the only thing that's left is I want to crop the image a little bit, since right there on the left side, this area is a little bit confusing, so I want to crop it out. Okay, much better. And that's it for editing this image. I hope it was helpful and interesting. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.